So welcome back. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss the physical systems represented by differential equation. So this is very common question that suppose if I write some kind of differential equation like x dot equal to ftx, you can see that this particular differential equation. So this is somehow mathematical equation where x is some kind of for physical system x is a state, but for mathematical framework that may be anything. And after that we have some kind of function here that is explicitly depending upon the time as well as this variable x. Now question is that if I write this kind of differential equation, so that always represents some kind of physical system or not. So we know that if I have some kind of physical system, then I can represent that physical system using some kind of mathematical equation. Now I am going to check the reverse problem. Suppose if some mathematical equation is given, then that mathematical equation is going to represent some physical system or not. All mathematical equation is going to represent some physical system, or there exists some kind of restriction. So this question is very important. Why this question is very important? Suppose you have some physical system and you have used some kind of approach to model that system, and after getting model you are not able to completely convince yourself that whatever model you are going to get, that is okay or not. So using this method, at least you are able to understand that whatever mathematical model you are going to represent, that is correct or not, or some problem with that particular mathematical model. And due to that reason, reverse question is very important. So if you see the linear system means where superposition principle is going to satisfy. So at that particular system, these kind of things is very much obvious. And due to that reason, whenever we are reading the linear control theory, at that time we are not checking these kind of a statement that linear differential equation is going to represent some system or not. Most of time it is possible to show that whatever discussion I am going to carry out for nonlinear system is particularly very much obvious for the linear system. I will tell you that why I am claiming this. So let us try to see the statement, and using that statement we are going to see various different property of nonlinear differential equation. So what basically we are telling, that this particular mathematical equation, whatever mathematical equation we have written here, this particular and this is you all are now already knowing that this is autonomous system, and particularly means physical system. If physical system is represented by this, is called autonomous system. Here I am assuming that time, positive time, I am just going to consider, and x belongs to Rn, and I have some kind of initial condition. One more important point is that whenever we are representing physical system, then we are always writing the initial condition. Because why this is important? Because we want to know what is futuristic behavior of some kind of physical system, and how basically futuristic behavior comes into picture by solving this equation. And for solution, this kind of initial condition is required. We have already discussed about that. Now let us try to see that what kind of a statement is actually required in order to represent some kind of mathematical equation to some kind of physical system. So first important statement is called existence of a solution. So why basically we are talking about existence of a solution? So reason behind that is, suppose that I have some kind of equation, and what we are going to see that in that particular equation, suppose I have x dot equal to f tx, this equation I have. After that, what is our main aim? That if I know the initial condition, so initial condition is xt0. After that, what we are knowing the dynamical equation, so x dot equal to ftx is known to us. After that, we are going to see what is xt. So for engineering system, whatever futuristic behavior, what we expect that xt will exist for all t greater than equal to 0. And in other word, we are going to note or we are going to predict the future or determine the futuristic behavior using this kind of initial condition and the knowledge of this kind of equation. So this futuristic behavior xt, that is called the solution. Okay, so we can able to know this xt provided we are able to solve this non-linear equation. And solution of non-linear equation is most of time that is not obvious, but this is not the case of the linear equation. So if you see the linear equation, then we are able to talk the solution. So I am going to just write the linear equation. So linear equation, suppose if I have x dot equal to axt, so here t is everywhere, t is implicit here, so plus but. So you can see that this system is linear time invariant system. And for linear time invariant system, if I know that xt0 equal to x0, then I can write the solution xt. During the linear control theory course, you might have seen that people are writing solution like this. So without any proof, I am going to write the solution. So please check this solution from the linear control theory course, bu tau into d tau. So now basically what we are telling, that if I have some kind of system which is represented by this kind of differential equation, then I can always able to calculate the futuristic value xt if I know the system matrix A and B and initial condition, because I know the starting time of my experiment, I know the A and B, I know the control at each and every moment, and due to that reason, I can able to write the solution in this form. So this form is called closed form. Closed form means somehow I can able to express solution of this equation always in this particular form. So this solution also, sometime if you read the mathematics book, then people are writing this kind of solution is called closed form solution. So I have closed form solution. Now if you see the LTV system, so this is a story about LTI system. So at least for LTI system, I can able to write the closed form solution. So now I am going to check that is it possible to extend this kind of solution for the general LTV system, means x dot equal to at and xt plus bt into ut. So and again I am telling that xt0 equal to x0, and for this particular system it is possible to show that again I can able to write the solution, closed form solution. And closed form solution is given like some kind of, this is called a state transition matrix. And again, I am not going to discuss what is meaning of a state transition matrix in this particular course. So idea is that if you know this matrix, then you are able to guess the futuristic solution in closed form. Again, t0 to t, this is phi t and tau b tau u tau into d tau. In this way we can able to write, and where this matrix, a state transition matrix of this particular system at into xt. Okay, so there are various way to calculate the value of this state transition matrix phi, and again we are able to write the closed form solution. So what we found that if we have some kind of differential equation that is either linear time invariant or linear time varying. Linear time varying, why? Because this AT matrix and BT matrix both are function of time, then I can able to write the closed form solution. Now we are going to see that similar kind of a story for the nonlinear system, and here you can see that in this particular lecture I am going to talk about the non-autonomous system. Why? You can see here that if I am able to express the solution in this form, and if I calculate phi t t0, that is a state transition matrix for x dot equal to a t x t, then from here we are able to recover this solution, means previous solution whatever I have written. It means that in this particular case a state transition matrix phi t t0 is nothing but e a t minus t0, like this. So if I consider the generalized case LTV system, linear time varying system, then solution for linear time invariant system is obvious. So similarly, if we are able to solve this equation with non-autonomous equation, then solution for this autonomous equation f x t and with initial condition x t 0 equal to x 0 and where x t belongs to Rn, that is obvious. So if we are able to make sure the result about this particular equation, so similar kind of result I can able to generalize for this class of system, and due to that reason we are going to talk about some more complete class, that is non-autonomous system. So here we have explicit presence of time. Now in order to represent this system to some physical system, first requirement, or this is the very very basic requirement, that this particular mathematical differential equation has some kind of solution, at least one solution we expect for all t greater than or equal to t0. Otherwise, if solution will not exist, then how can I claim that if I know the initial condition xt0, if I know the explicit value of time when we have started the experiment, then I can able to predict the future t. So here you can see that, and here obviously I have dynamical system. So if we don't have solution, then I cannot claim that I, if initial condition is known to me, time is known to me, differential equation is known to me, then I can solve this. So if solution will not exist, then we cannot predict this, or we cannot able to talk about the value of xt. So in order to represent any differential equation to some kind of physical system, first requirement is the existence of solution. So if solution will not exist, then that particular differential equation is not going to represent some kind of physical system. We are going to see that the statement that if I have differential equation, then we have always solution or not. If we have always solution, then there is no meaning of this statement. But it is possible to show that at least we can create some kind of system which don't have any solution, okay, or at least classical solution. We don't have any classical solution. Classical solution means we have certain way to talk about the solution, so that kind of solution will not exist. Another requirement, you can see that is little bit stronger than first one, that local existence and uniqueness of solution. So here we are going to talk solution for all t greater than equal to t0, but in some specific problem, and most of time that is the case, we are only concentrated on solution for some time t. Suppose that if I launch some kind of rocket, then we are just concerned solution for some time interval. It might possible in days, years, or some more period. So most of time we are talking about the local solution. Local solution means for some sufficient small t0, we will start at t0, and after that we are looking for t0 plus epsilon. So for a small time t0, we are going to see the solution. That is the meaning. We are not going to claim that we have solution for all t greater than or equal to t0. So that is meaning of word local. And after that we are going to talk about the uniqueness. Uniqueness is very, very important. Why uniqueness is important? Because most of time, whenever we are going to develop some kind of model, we have to give guarantee that whatever solution for some initial condition, that should be unique. And I have several time I have talked about this particular uniqueness of solution, and I have given example. Suppose we have constructed some kind of aeroplane, and if I start from one place, then and if I have some kind of control sequence or some kind of dynamics, then we have to give guarantee that either I am going to land to some place A or B. Okay, if we don't know where I am going to land, then no one can able to take ticket to that particular aeroplane. So due to that reason, uniqueness is very, very important in case of engineering system. So meaning of this particular statement, local existence and uniqueness of solution, is that suppose if I have some system, and again non-autonomous system I have taken, but same statement is true for the autonomous case, has exactly one solution for all sufficiently small value of t. You can see that now we are not going to expect at least one solution, exactly one solution we are going to talk. Exactly why? Because I want to talk about uniqueness of the solution. So after some time I am going to show you some kind of differential equation which has not exactly one solution. It might possible we have infinite many solution. Okay, so if we have infinite many solution, then what kind of basic problem comes into picture, and what we can comment in terms of the physical system. We are going to look that kind of examples just after some time. And local, due to that reason, we are just going to concern for the small value of time t. So we are going to look solution between t to some kind of t plus epsilon, and where epsilon we are assuming that is very, very small, like this. So in this period we are going to look the solution. So sometime epsilon might be very, 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 very large also, that depending on the situation of the dynamical system. Now another requirement, third requirement, is you can see that is global existence and uniqueness of the solution. So this word global, that is different from the last sentence where we are talking about the local. So global means, now you can see that again, uniqueness means we are going to talk about exactly one solution, but here in this particular mathematical equation, now we are going to talk about unique solution for this time interval t0 to infinity. It means that now we are telling that you can go anywhere, there exists exactly one solution, that is called global existence and uniqueness of the solution. And last one, that is fourth statement, that is talking about the well-posedness. And well-posedness is very, very important property. What this property is telling, that expect from the global existence and uniqueness of solution, we also want to see that solution is continuously depending on initial condition or not. So what basically we are telling, I have some kind of equation ftx, and if I am going to give some kind of initial condition, so if some solution is generated, that solution should be continuously depending on this value x t0, then we are able to track the solution. So somewhere, if we lose the dependency of x t0 on x t, even if solution will exist for t0 to infinity, we are not able to track that solution, and due to that reason, well-posedness is required. So what we found, that in order to represent dynamical system, at least one of the statements should be satisfied, at least. So I have four statements, that is existence of the solution. So solution should be exist. If solution will not exist, then we cannot tell that mathematical equation or nonlinear mathematical equation is going to represent some kind of physical system. After that, only existence of solution is not enough for the engineering system. So we need uniqueness of solution also. And at least if I am going to do experiment up to t plus epsilon time, then in that particular interval, we want some kind of unique solution. And what is meaning of global existence and uniqueness of solution? So for all t greater than equal to t0, I need some kind of solution. And after that, we have further requirement is called well-poseness, that whatever solution that should be depending on the initial condition of the state variable or whatever you can tell. So if that is continuously depending on the state variable, it is possible to tell that whatever solution that is detectable, I can able to comment about the solution for all t equal to greater than t0, and I know that how basically solution is evolving with respect to different initial condition. So at least if at least one statement is satisfied out of that four, then we can tell that whatever differential equation that is x dot equal to ftx, that is going to represent some kind of system. Okay, but what is condition of the statement? If you see carefully, then a statement, first statement is little less stronger, after that second one is more stronger. You can see that we are just talking about local, and after that third one become more stronger, and fourth one become most strongest statement all of these four. So it is possible to show that if our mathematical equation is going to satisfy the fourth statement, that is very very appropriate to represent some kind of physical system. So wherever I have some kind of differential equation, you can get differential equation from the modeling, or you can by first principle. Modeling by first principle means you can use some kind of fundamental law, and after that you are going to get some kind of mathematical equation, or you can estimate the model from the data. So you have input data and output data, and after that if you generate some kind of mathematical equation, and suppose that equation is nonlinear, so again in order to represent that particular system, you have to check that fourth statement is satisfied or not. And due to that reason, most of time by checking fourth statement, we are able to understand that whatever model I have actually get from the data or from the first principle or from the energy principle, that is appropriate. So in this way, basically we are able to convince ourselves that whatever model we have received, that is at least okay for representing some kind of physical system. So up to here, anyone has confusion, then please let me know. Anyone? Are you able to understand all four statement? Okay, now let us try to see that why I have written first statement, because you can see that first statement is very very simple. We are just talking about the existence of the solution. So we are going to see that, is it possible to construct some kind of equation where solution will not exist? And answer of this question is yes. Let us try to see. Here I have taken very very simple system. You can see that here I have x dot equal to u, so you can interpret as a control input. So I have some kind of system, first order system. You can see that here u belongs to R and xt belongs to R. So I have first order system that is represented by xt equal to u. Now I have to construct u, and after that I will generate xt. So what I am going to do, I am going to construct u based on on-off logic. On-off logic means, suppose you can see here that once xt is greater than 0, at that time this signum function is positive plus 1 and negative sign is here, so due to that reason that become minus 1. So I have selected this kind of control action. So I have first order system and I have to design this control. So what I have done, I have defined control by on-off logic. It means that what we are telling that whenever I have first order system, so I can represent by some kind of real line. And what basically we are telling that if xt is greater than 0 in this side, at that time x dot rate of change should be negative, that is minus 1. Okay, so suppose that this is equation of error or something, and I want to decrease towards the equilibrium point. And equilibrium point here, I am assuming that xt equal to 0, so that is the equilibrium point. So my requirement is that I have to converge towards the equilibrium point, and due to that reason I have selected this kind of logic, that if xt that is greater than 0, so I want to maintain rate of change less than 0, so I can move towards the equilibrium point. And similar kind of situation on this side, that xt is less than 0, then x dot t that is greater than 0, so I can move in this particular direction, and I have selected this kind of logic. But you can see here that when we are at equilibrium point, at that time I have selected, suppose I have selected plus 1, okay, so I don't know how to select control logic at the equilibrium point. So due to that reason I have selected, okay, I am going to define when xt less than equal to 0, at that time also I am going to maintain plus 1. And in this particular system, now you can see that this system is represented now like some kind of fxt, something like this. So this is, I have some kind of autonomous system, and we are going to check the solution for this particular, because I am going to talk about the first statement that there exists at least one solution or node. Here you can see that whenever I am writing this kind of equation, x dot t equal to minus 1 and x dot t equal to plus 1 for xt less than equal to 0. What does it mean? Since we are talking about the rate of change of this variable xt, so that should be at least one time continuously differentiable. So meaning of this is continuously differentiable at least one time. Okay, anyone has confusion why I have written this statement? You can see from here that in order to exist this kind of equation, x dot t should exist. And what is basic requirement for that from calculus? X should be continuous. If that is not continuous, then I cannot able to define the derivative. And due to that reason, whatever solution that is generated from this equation, that should be differentiable. So rate of change, that is called vector field. You have just learned from the previous classes the meaning of vector field. So x dot t equal to fx. So this fx is called vector field. So what we are telling, that xt is continuous, but x dot t may or may not be continuous. Okay, so in this particular example, you can see that vector field is discontinuous. Why that is discontinuous? Because xt just greater than 0, I have different value, and less than 0, I have different value. But whatever solution, that should be continuous. So now what I am going to do, I am going to select this initial condition x0 equal to 0. So suppose at the time when we have started our experiment, at that time my initial condition equal to 0, and I have this kind of equation. So what I have to do, I have to put t equal to 0 in this equation. And if you put t equal to 0 in this equation, you can see that I have x dot 0, and at that time I have sine 0. And we have just defined that whenever xt, this kind of situation I have, xt less than 0, less than equal to 0, at that time plus 1, due to that reason I have defined x dot 0 equal to plus 1. Now try to see that what basically we are telling, that we are at equilibrium point 0, and at that time x dot 0 is plus 1. So x dot 0 is plus 1, it means that if I start from x0, then I can move in this particular direction, so right hand direction, and due to that reason xt become greater than 0. So same kind of things I have written in the next statement, that in this particular, for very very small time where epsilon is just greater than 0, you can see that xt greater than 0. And once xt greater than 0, now again club xt greater than 0 here, so So if you club xt greater than 0 here, you can see that now I have another situation, that is x dot t equal to minus sine t, and if this is positive, then that become minus 1. What does it mean? That one point I have two different slope. So initially I have slope plus 1, and after that, by seeing this vector field, what we have seen, that is minus 1. It means that whatever function xt, that should not be continuous. So by seeing this, what we can tell, that whatever, if I have this kind of logic, then somehow I cannot tell that whatever t map to xt is continuous, or at least x dot t is continuous. Okay, so due to that reason, whatever this solution, that is not a proper solution. Anyone has confusion? Binay?
No, sir.
Okay, so what does it mean? What is conclusion of this? So suppose that if you are designing some kind of on-off control for first order system, and if you define this kind of logic, okay, xt greater than equal to 0 minus 1, xt less than equal to 0 plus 1, then what happens, that whatever futuristic trajectory comes into picture, okay, that is not correct one, and due to that reason I cannot select control by this logic. Now one can doubt that why classical solution doesn't exist. This is due to discontinuity, but that is not the case. I will give you the next example, where if you change the logic, okay, so conclusion is that no classical solution starting from x0 exists. Now remark is that lack of continuity of vector field doesn't preclude the existence of classical solution. What we are telling, that in previous example, what we found, that xt is discontinuous, means vector field is discontinuous. You can see that discontinuity of vector field in this particular place, and due to that reason one can think that solution is not exist, but that is not the case. What I am going to do now, I am going to change the logic. So I am going to change this logic, control logic, like this. So now again our definition remains the same, minus 1 for xt greater than 0, x0. Now we have just included this statement, that once we are at equilibrium point, so we are in first in this real axis, because xt belongs to R. So we are here. So whenever we are here, at that time vector field x dot, you can see that x dot equal to 0. So x dot t we are going to define as a 0. So you can see that again at x 0 equal to 0, this is discontinuous, means vector field, means right hand side is called vector field, that is discontinuous. But at this time, now I am going to check the solution. Again I am going to start from the x0, because most crucial point is discontinuous point. Due to that reason I am going to talk about this x0 equal to 0. And suppose now what I am going to see, that suppose x, whatever initial condition, that is going to lie like this, x0 to x0, I have just perturbed the system in positive side. And if you perturb the system in positive side, then you have equation like xt equal to minus 1, and xt equal to minus 1, you can see that this is my solution. So if we are at t equal to 0, then again this solution will satisfy, because t equal to 0 I have x0 equal to x0, and this becomes 0. So due to that reason I can tell that, okay, if I am just in forward direction, at that time I have solution like this. Suppose that if you are in the left hand side of the equilibrium point, again I have solution. So this is the meaning, that my initial condition lie between somewhere between minus x0. This is called maximal solution, means at least we can able to see solution for this particular initial condition. And at that time you can see that if you solve this equation x dot t equal to plus 1, then I have solution like this. Again if you put t equal to 0, you can see that 0 solution is also satisfied. And due to that reason we are telling that in this particular case we have classical solution, and x, so from, and finally we know that x0 equal to 0, because x dot equal to 0. So we can tell that for all t 0 to infinity, either initial condition is positive and negative, we have always some solution. Okay, so what basically we have noticed that it made possible that vector field or right hand side of the differential equation, this is discontinuous, but still I have some kind of continuous trajectory xt, that is possible. Okay, so and due to that reason, whenever if you have some idea of on off control, you might have seen that people are defining on off control in this way, not in that way, that xt less than equal to 0, then that is plus. They do not include this here. If somehow by wrong logic we will include this here, then what happens? We don't have solution. So that will not represent any engineering system. Now here, what kind of conclusion we have? So at least for this example, I have global existence and uniqueness of solution. So I can able to talk solution for any time interval. Okay, so we don't have only local solution, we have solution, and that solution is also unique. Why I am telling unique? Because for whenever initial condition that is positive, then I have different solution. Whenever initial condition negative, that is different solution, but both solution is unique with respect to the initial condition, and due to that reason we have also unique solution in this particular case. Let us try to see some kind of example where we don't have uniqueness of solution. Solution exists, but that is not unique. So in previous case, solution is exist for all t greater than equal to t0, means up to infinity, and whatever solution that is going to exist, that is also unique. Just by solving we are checking, we are not going to state any kind of mathematical statement at this time. We have first order equation and we know how to solve first order equation, and after that we are making some kind of conclusion or observation. So you can see that in another example, I have taken x dot t equal to 1 by 2 xt. In this particular example, what we are assuming that whenever I have this equation, so obviously whenever we have written like this, at that time we are telling that xt 0 not equal to 0. Okay, so it is better that whenever you are writing this kind of equation, please write also this. And suppose xt not equal to 0, at that time x dot equal to 1 by 2 xt, that is not going to define. So you can assume like this. And suppose I am going to start from x0 equal to 0. So what we are telling, that at x dot t equal to 1 by 2 xt, when xt not equal to 0, otherwise that is 0. You can assume like that. Okay. So why we haven't assumed in this particular case? Because if you assume that kind of case, then that become equilibrium point. Okay. So due to that reason, okay, for time being, you can see that I have this kind of equation and I am assuming that xt not equal to 0. And suppose I am defining that, okay, since this equation is not defined, so I have defined another equation x0 equal to 0. So if system at 0, then initial condition equal to 0, like that. Now you can see that if you have right solution like this, so it is possible to show that this solution can satisfy this equation. So either plus you can take, and it is very easy to check what you can do. You can just differentiate this. So if you differentiate this, then x dot t equal to, suppose you have considered t power half. So if you consider t power half, at that time I have half t power minus 1 by 2. So again, you can see that I can write 2 t power half, and you already know that xt equal to t power half. So you can just substitute xt here. So you are able to reconstruct same equation. Similarly, what you can do, you can start from minus t power half, and it is possible to show that again you are able to get same kind of equation. So it means that from the one place, and you can see that this equation also satisfies this, that if you satisfy t equal to 0, then it means that two solution is going to generate from one point x0 equal to 0, and one solution is t power half, another solution is minus t power half, and due to that reason we are telling that solution exists. So first statement is satisfied, but second statement, that is called the uniqueness of the solution. So uniqueness is lost
here.
Okay, so since uniqueness is lost, so I cannot tell that this particular differential equation is going to represent some kind of physical system where uniqueness is required. So please do not confuse. Some engineering system nowadays, you might have seen that we are going to construct some kind of missile system where from one missile I have two different kind of missile is going to generate, some missile is going to generate, and that can going to hit two different target. Okay, so at that time it might possible I am going to construct this kind of solution. But almost all physical system, most of the physical system, we need the uniqueness of solution. Okay, now let us try to see the another example. So this is this example. So what is main motivation to take this example? That we are going to talk about the lack of the uniqueness of solution. So in this case, no unique solution. Okay, so in first case, what we found that there do not exist solution if we are going to apply some kind of wrong logic. Second case, it might possible solution exist, but that is not unique for particularly for some equilibrium, some initial condition, solution is not unique. Now let us try to see the next example. So next example, again, that is everywhere you can see that I have just taken the example of first order system. And why? Because at least we are able to solve the equation, and after that we are going to make some kind of conclusion. That is our main motivation. So if suppose I have this kind of equation, and it is possible to show that solution of this equation, either you can solve or and do checking like this. Suppose if you know the solution, then what you can do, you can start differentiating. So if you differentiate x dot t, so 10 t equal to sec square t, and sec square t equal to 1 plus 10 square t, so like this. So again I am able to construct same kind of things like this. Here you can see that from the t equal to 0, so this solution is also satisfied because 10 0 equal to 0. But what is problem? That as t tending towards the pi by 2, so at that time this solution is going to tend towards the infinity. So you can see the behavior that as we are approaching towards this point pi by 2, at that time solution is approaching towards the infinity. What is meaning of infinity? Anyone can tell? Silpi, are you here? So could you please tell what is meaning of infinity?
Does not exist finite values. System does not.
Is that whenever we are writing infinity, it means that we are not sure. Okay. That when I have t equal to pi by 2, then what is value of xt? We are not able to predict. Okay. That is some kind of vague quantity. And due to that reason, we are telling that solution only exists up to pi by 2. So when that is exactly equal to pi by 2, I don't know the solution. So whenever we are writing infinity in the case of our analysis, then we are able to interpret that as some kind of vague quantity. Okay, that is not some kind of measurable quantity. Anyone has confusion on this point? So what happens here? You can see that this is called finite escape time. What does it mean? That in finite time, solution is going to tend towards the infinity. Okay, so solution is just going to exist between these two intervals, 0 to pi by 2. And this is called the local existence, because solution at least exists for this time interval, and that time interval is nothing but 0 to pi by 2, here open interval, and this solution is also unique. So at least I can tell that up to this time interval I have unique solution, because xt is, if you plot this graph, xt equal to 10t, so that is unique. So I can able to give guarantee that solution is unique, but solution is only exist up to some time. So this is not global solution, this is some kind of local solution. And whatever this kind of phenomena that is only exist in case of nonlinear system. So linear system, there is no question of finite escape time. So this phenomena is called finite escape time, means in finite time our solution is tending towards infinity. So again, this is going to represent some kind of physical system, because at least I have local solution. So anyone, could you please guess that where this kind of solution is required? Baby Dana, are you here? Okay, Nidhi, could you please comment that where this kind of solution is required? Do you have any idea?
For speed or location?
Suppose that in finite time, if I have to create huge energy, okay, suppose I have to do some kind of destruction process, okay, so at that time it might possible one can use this kind of equation, okay, because in finite time you can see that my solution is going to explode, okay. So suppose if I am going to create some kind of bomb or some kind of destructive object, at that time one can use the help of this kind of equation. Anyone has confusion? Okay, now let us try to come to the next example. So again, next example I have constructed, again we are going to talk about the finite escape time. You can see here that again solution can be represented like xt equal to 1 by t minus 1. So as t tending towards the 1, at that time this interval or this denominator is tending towards the 0, so 1 by 0 is infinity. So due to that reason, here again solution is going to exist between 0 to 1. Okay, so again this is unique solution, okay, and after that this is local solution, not the global solution. Okay, anyone has confusion? And here I have defined explicitly that at x 0, because I have to check that this solution should be satisfy this condition as well as this solution should be satisfy this equation. So you can just check by differentiating both sides. So you have to take this, and it is possible to show that if you take this differentiation, then we can generate this equation. Okay, now next example I am going to construct. So that is like this, x dot equal to minus x cube, and suppose you have x t 0 equal to x 0, this kind of initial condition. It is possible to show, again by checking this, it is possible to show that this is the solution, okay, and it is possible to show that this solution exists for t greater than equal to t 0. And how to check this is solution? I have already told you that is very easy. What you can do, you can take the differentiation both hand side, and after that check that this equation is going to generate or not. From the analysis of geometrical analysis also, you are able to see that this solution exists for all time or not. Suppose here I am assuming that xt belongs to R, so I have this kind of real axis. Suppose if you are here, initial condition is positive, at that time you can see that x dot t is negative because I have minus x cube. And if you are here, then x 0, that is less than 0, then x dot is always greater than 0, so I can move in this direction. And you can start anywhere, even if xt is very large, we are going to converge towards the origin, okay. And equilibrium point I have, just if you equate this, it means that you can see that what is property, we have global solution, we have unique solution, and each and every moment you can see that solution is also depending on the initial condition. So this is called, solution is called well posed, okay. So meaning of well posedness of solution, that if you know the initial condition, so with that initial condition you are able to construct some kind of unique solution for all t greater than equal to t 0, okay. So this is called well posed system. Anyone has confusion? So we are just going to state some kind of definition. So at least this kind of system, I have well posed solution. Now I am going to just verify that you have understood the point or not. So here Now you can see that just so anyone can comment about this. So suppose now I am going to write the equation x dot equal to axt. Okay, so could you please tell me that which kind of statement is satisfied here? This is simple LTI system. Ruchi, could you please comment? Suppose here I have this kind of equation. So here I have a first statement, that is obvious. I have existence of solution. So solution is unique or not unique, that is local or global or well posed or not. What one can comment?
It's a global and well posed.
Okay, global. So global is obvious. And after that, is this solution is well posed? How to check well posedness of solution?
Sir, it should depend on initial condition.
So just you can solve it, and we have just seen the solution EAT minus T0 and X0. You can see that every time that is depending on the initial condition also. Okay, mm-hmm. Anyone had confusion? So this solution, so due to that reason, whenever we have some kind of linear system, at that time well posedness is obvious. Okay, now suppose if I have this kind of equation. Okay, so Binay, could you please tell comment that this is well posed or not? X dot equal to at into xt, and again xt belongs to Rn. So I have LTV system, linear time varying system. So solution is well posed or not? So for LTI system, what we found, that solution is going to depend on the initial condition. So again, if you know the solution,
yes.
So again, this is well posed. Because again, you can see that every time this solution is going to depend on the initial condition, and that is unique and going to exist for all t greater than or equal to t0. And due to that reason, for linear system, people are not talking about this kind of a statement. Anyone has confusion? Because solution is always well posed. And well posed means they are going to satisfy all condition, all four condition, because the strongest condition is well posedness. Okay, let us try to see one more example of uniqueness problem, because non-unique, somehow whenever you have non-unique solution, you have to remove that non-unique solution. Okay, and most of time that creates some kind of difficulty. Let us try to see that x dot t equal to root xt. So at least here we have solution. Okay, and in order to represent some kind of engineering system or physical system, at least we have solution, one solution. But if we have unique solution, then that is much more better. So here you can see that for this equation, I have solution like t minus c. C is some kind of constant which is greater than the time t equal to c. So if you define this kind of solution, and again if you take the derivative, here again I am assuming that xt that belongs to R. So I have one dimensional equation. You can see here that if you are going to set different constant, it means that if you start your experiment at 5 second or 10 second or 20 second, then you have different solution. Okay, so I have different solution, and that solution I have represented like this. So first solution, if t equal to 0, then you have solution like this. But if you t equal to something, t equal to suppose c1, then you have solution like this. T equal to c2, then you have solution like this, like t equal to c2. So for each time you have some kind of solution. Okay, so you have some different solution from the equilibrium point. Okay, anyone has confusion? So if you are going to select t equal to 5 second, at that time you are going to follow this trajectory. But if you select t equal to 10 second, then your trajectory is going to change. And due to that reason, we are telling that from one point x equal to 0, I have infinite many solutions. Okay, and try to see that this kind of equation is also existing in nature, because at least we have one solution. So I am going to take very simple example of water tank system. Okay, so everybody has there is some kind of tank where we are storing the water. Okay, now you can see that this, if you see this equation carefully, then this equation and whatever previously I have written, this equation, that equation don't have any difference, only I have negative sign here and some constant is here. Okay, again it is possible to show that here we have uniqueness in non-uniqueness in forward time. Here due to negative time I have non-uniqueness in the backward time. Why I am telling backward? Suppose that in morning if you went to attend the class, at that time tank is full. Okay, and when you came back to your house, at that time you found that tank is empty. Is it possible to guess that when time tank become empty? Is it possible to guess? Anyone? What I am telling, when in morning when you have used your tank and what you have checked that tank is totally full. Okay, and when you came back after attending the class, at that time tank is empty. Is it possible to guess that when tank become empty? No, it is not possible. Okay, so why that is not possible? Because I have non-uniqueness of solution in backward time. It might possible that it fully depend on the use. Okay, so you went to the class and within 10 second it might possible tank become open empty. It might possible after 20 second if people has used the slow use, then that become empty. Okay, so this kind of physical example. So in this particular example it is possible to show that I can tell that suppose now if this tank is empty, so I can give guarantee that when this become full, suppose that if I know the rate of change of coming of this water, then I can able to calculate the time when this tank become full. But if tank is empty, then I cannot tell that this when this tank become empty. So in forward time, if empty, then I can know that when this become full. Okay, but if that is empty, then I cannot tell that when this become empty, because in backward time we have several solutions. Okay, so this is the non-uniqueness of solution in backward time. Okay, anyone has confusion? So okay, if you don't have confusion, now I am going to conclude the today's lecture. So in today's lecture what we found, that non-linear system is again very very much rich, because they have sometimes they have local solution, they have some kind of solution which will escape to infinity in finite time, so that is called finite escape time, and that kind of possibility is only in case of non-linear differential equation. What we found, that if we have some kind of well posed solution, then we are able to model our system in the perfect way, because every time we are able to understand that what is the dependency of initial condition on the solution. Okay, so whenever you are develop some kind of mathematical model to study some kind of system, or you are going to develop some kind of system which you want that will work perfectly, then you have to make sure that whatever solution that is going to generate from that particular differential equation, that should be well posed. And after that, in the next part of this course, we are going to see that whenever a notion of stability comes into the picture, at that time whatever differential equation or nonlinear differential equation that will satisfy that kind of property, means well posedness of the solution. Okay, so if now you have any confusion, then please let me know. So lecture is over from my side. So if you have any confusion, then please let me know. Anyone?